Mike's Daily Podcast.
Here we are on Tuesday. I'm podcasting like I've done for almost 10 years. That's crazy. Hey, I lost a fan on my Facebook page. One fan disappeared. Oh, who needed them? Anyway, Cafe Anyways, where we are somewhere in Podcastro Valley Mont, the last place on Earth. I'm Mike Matthews. Today, we will speak to
Mike's Daily Podcast.
Benita, the disgruntled fiddle player, and the brewmaster. Oh boy, what a day yesterday with the dog.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
He's been a great dog for, gosh, all his life. And even when he was a puppy, he was pretty cool. He didn't eat up a lot of stuff or cause me to drool. Well, he drooled. But he was a great dog, and he's still a great dog. But now he's much older, and let's just say he's old, and things don't work as well when you're old.
Mike's Daily Podcast.
That's just how it is. He's wise. He's wonderful. He's still a
Mike's
hoot.
Daily.
Makes me laugh.
Podcast.
But there's things that happen. I won't go into detail, but not the best of things. And, well, I had to deal with a bunch of that yesterday. And then, well, I'm kind of a manager now. And somebody was not going to do one little teeny weeny thing that I asked him to. He's like, ah, ha, ha, good luck with that. And so that's like a little thing, not a big thing, but a little thing. And so that made my day all the more interesting. And then there was, what do you call that? The sun goes down so damn fast now. I can't go out and go on my walks. And my dog doesn't want to walk anymore as much. So it was one of those kind of Mondays. And the best part was doing the laundry, because some things had to be washed because of the aforementioned matter. And I'm washing stuff, and I go to remove the lint catcher from this pipe that pushes all the water out of the washer. And, well, I did it at the wrong time, and I pushed. Water ended up all over the place is what happened, because it was coming out the pipe, and I didn't have it in the thing it was supposed to go into. So I made it more of a mess than I should have. It was one of those days.
And here's today's podcast picture.
And I have a picture of all of it right here. No, I don't. Not yet. But hey, look at this. The hockey team, known as the Barracuda, they beat the Gulls. The Barracuda beat the Gulls. They're from San Diego. That's such great news. I know you wanted an update. And that's about it today. Oh gosh. So, like I mentioned, I was washing a bunch of my dog's stuff, like his blankets and everything. And I put the blankets in the room, and I'm trying to go to sleep, and all of a sudden, like, I am coughing like crazy. Just because you wash a dog blanket does not mean it's clean. Oh my gosh, there was so much stuff in the air. And this is from a guy who survived the whole smoke from all the fires we had up here recently. Campfire. It was, I don't know, I could not breathe. I was just coughing away. It was crazy. Or maybe it was just suddenly all that smoke from the past several weeks. I mean, we breathed the stuff that we Californians, Northern Californians, breathe is unbelievable. I don't know what the long-term repercussions of all this is. I am hoping for the best. And the people that wore masks, most of the masks that people were wearing didn't even help them. So it was not a good time. Plus, the people that wore masks looked ridiculous. And just, you know, it was hypocritical because a lot of them were then smoking pot or whatever. Because it's the Bay Area. Everybody smokes pot. All the time. Constantly. And so the podcast picture today is of this wonderful place in, what is it called? Oh, my gosh. Okay. It's in Monterey, California. in the Cannery Row area. There's this place called the Studio Cafe. It's a neat little coffee place. It's got this little patio. I want to say that cafe anyway looks a lot like this, because it should. And somebody's got their golden retriever sitting on them, and you see these little feet sticking out. It's funny. And there's some succulents, some agave, some, what do you call them? It's got this brick pavered patio with old bricks. That's the one cool thing. In Benicia, this is what they got in Benicia, too. A lot of the houses, a lot of the yards are pavered with these old bricks that actually came from the East Coast. And they were used as ballast for a lot of the boats. These bricks go back so long ago. And this place in Monterey and Cannery Row has the same kind of effect. It's called the Studio Cafe, and I don't mean to give them a free plug, because they certainly didn't give me a free coffee, a pour-over coffee that I think cost way more than I was expecting. But it's interesting, because they also have these studios, and they do dance lessons, yoga, they do that whole thing. So it's a mind and body place for your mind and your body, because you kind of need one and the other together. How about your spirit? Who knows? But this happy golden retriever sitting on this guy or this woman, I don't know who this is, but I see these shoes poking out. And you can see that picture at mikesdailypodcast.com. The new website features, well, it's a little bit more streamlined. All the stuff that was causing me problems where my web server company shut down my website because they're telling me that I had malware on it. Well, all that stuff is gone. All the plugins. And this is what I suggest to you if you do a website. Like, I have a WordPress website. And WordPress offers all these plugins. But they really don't manage what the plugins do and what they got behind them. And it's a third-party thing, so they don't really care. So you end up with all kinds of malware and stuff that end up on your website. And I've been lucky so far. I've had this website for over 5 years now, and nothing's happened. So now I've cleaned it all out, and it's looking pretty good. So the only thing that's not working, my phone number that I have, I do it kind of like a blog, a bloggity blog, and you have to preface every blog with a bloggity in the beginning. And it's got the phone number, and as I click on it on a desktop, it says it wants to open in an app. But when you click on it on your phone, if you're looking at it on a browser, it doesn't always open the phone. So you might have to actually, if you wanted to call me at 336-MM-DAILY, you might have to do that just manually. I know this is all fascinating podcast stuff. So there's a guy who does a Christian morning show on, I think, a music station. And I think he's heard nationally. And his name is Brent. And he talks like this. Hey guys, this is Brent. Hey, I want to tell you about, if you want to refinance your home, there's a really great way to do it. Like, this just kind of matter-of-fact kind of voice. Like, I'm not in your face. I'm just telling you. I'm standing over here. I'm off to the side. But I'm selling you something. Even though I'm off to the side, I'm selling you something. I'm kind of like a clown that's funny, right? A clown. Clowns are funny, but I'm a clown with a bomb, and that bomb might go off at any time. My name is Brent, and here's a bomb. Beware of Brent. That's all I'm saying. Did you hear that there's this radio station that banned "It's Cold Outside"? Baby, it's cold outside. Why? Okay, Mike, it's an awful song. No. What? There's 80,000 different versions. All of them suck, Mike. No, they don't. There's one or two good ones. The one that one of the radio stations I know well in the Bay Area plays is the Idina Menzel, the Michael Bublé. That duet. Yes. Okay, I see what you're saying. It is annoying. But still, it's a great song. Look, we've gotten to the part of the podcast where I go, look, Don't you love guests that are on as we go outside a cafe anyway, where we bring you Mike's Daily Podcast somewhere in Podcaster Valley? If you listen to any amount of talk radio where people interview someone, there's always somebody that says, look. They start off with a sentence that says, look. Or you'll hear someone start off with a sentence that says, so, da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And I think I did that on today's show. But there's a guy who hosts a conservative talk show. And after the elections, and they're still counting votes in a couple of elections that happened a month ago. It's just how it is. And this guy is such a sore loser. And when the whole Rick Scott thing in Florida was going on, he was railing against the liberals trying to steal the election. And like I've said, that is completely unnecessary. That tone is not warranted and should not be put and should not be allowed on FCC-regulated airwaves. It's annoying. That kind of sore loser attitude in voting in elections. Yes, we should be careful of... See, that's the thing. Voter fraud and the voter suppression. We've got two... Both sides are angry about the same thing. Different sides of the coin. But just the sore... People sound like such sore losers. And questioning elections and... It's got to be bipartisan. We all got to work together and basically say, look, we want elections to run fairly. We want people who want to vote... be able to vote, and we want the voting to be completely error-free. So we should work towards that end. I'm not a politician. I don't know how to do that, but that's what we should have a common goal with that. By the way, one of the funnest things to do as I wrap up the show, I may have mentioned this in a previous podcast, I'm a horrible texter. I cannot text very fast. By the way, if it takes more than 10 texts... to get something, to get an appointment, or let's say you wanted to get together with a friend, and you're texting back and forth more than 10 times, just so that you can meet up, then that's just never gonna happen. That gets so frustrating. So how about this day? Oh, that's not gonna work for me. How about this day? No, that's not gonna work for me. How about this day? No, how about this? No, we're both too busy. We can never, ever, ever get together. We should never... Isn't that a Taylor Swift song? But the point is, as I've said, that's my catchphrase, and I'm trying to get rid of it, is that my texting is bad, and I do a lot of the speech-to-text stuff. That's such a wonderful technology. Although Samsung, sometimes... just does not know what it's doing, and I'm talking, and I thought I've said a whole text, and it's got one word. I got my first word. So, and that was the first word, because I'm a millennial. And that's the end of the show. Hey, we went through the whole show without any sound effects. I don't think we did any, did we? Oh, so.
Right? Good.
Ending with a millennial. Thank you so much for listening to the show. I didn't say hi to anybody.
It's Benita the Rodeo Queen. I've been waiting outside all night. How y'all doing? And I got my horse, Nelly.
Hi, Nelly.
It's a disgruntled player, tell you what.
What?
Sorry about all that thing that happened with you with the washing machine and whatnot.
Thank you. Yeah, the washing machine. That was a fun washing experience last night. And look who else is here.
Oh, Mike, I make the delicious root beer pasta right now. I'll cut you. Oh, boy.
Happy early December to everyone, and thanks for listening to the show. Next show, it'll be the wonderful Shelley Shue, Madam something. Yeah, Madam Rutabaga Valentino and Bison Bentley. And that was episode 1757. 1757. 1757, thank you.
Mike's Daily Podcast is written and produced and performed by Mike Matthews. His podcast is super easy to find. Download or listen to his show and read his blog at mikesdailypodcast.com.
Email Mike now at mikesdailypodcast@gmail.com.
See you tomorrow. Bye.